In this tutorial, we shall demonstrate how to create a new Meteo site in PVSYST. PVSYST has a Meteo site database of over 2,500 predefined ground station sites. You can create new sites anywhere on Earth by pressing New. You can use the interactive map to select the location for the new site. The site search can be done either by name or by GPS coordinates. The characteristics of the site are summarized here. You must click on Accept to validate the location. The Geographic Coordinates tab summarizes the data for the site. You can manually fill in any missing data or rename the site the way you want. If you are not connected to the internet, you can skip the interactive map to directly fill in the coordinates and site information in this tab. You must choose the origin of the data to be imported. Meteonorm and NASA SSE are two sources of monthly data that are online or offline. PVGIS and NSRDB are two free sources providing TMY data. They require a working internet connection. Solcast and Future Sources are freemium data providers. They also require a working internet connection. Details of all Meteo data sources are available on the online help of PVSYST. Click on Import to get the data from the chosen site. The monthly weather window allows you to view the site values in monthly averages. You can change the name of the data source. You have the option to change the unit of irradiance. When changing units, a renormalization will be made according to the number of days in each month. The default unit is kilowatt hours per square meter per month or annually. The clearness index, KT, is a ratio of the horizontal global irradiance to the corresponding extraterrestrial irradiance. The global irradiance is measured on a horizontal plane. The ambient temperature for ground station is ideally measured under the following conditions: sheltered, 2 meters from the ground, and on 100 square meters of open grass. Please see the help for more details. This value is very important for the probabilistic approach after simulation for the calculations of P50 and P90. Your SIT file is now completed. You can save it by clicking on OK. It's very important to save the generated synthetic hourly file in order to be able to use this new site in the simulation. For PVGIS, NSRDB, Solcast, and Future Sources, this dialog asks you to save the TMY file obtained from the internet. In this window, you can check that your Meteo file has been generated. The .met and .sit files have been generated and can now be used in the simulation.